Okay, guys, we're about 8 minutes in. Can we get a rhythm check?
Still in VFib.
All right, let's go ahead and shock.
Everybody clear?
Clear.
Shocking. Shock delivered.
Continue for compressions. Andrew, can you please give 1 milligram of epi? Rebecca, are you okay on the chest?
Good.
We can switch out to the next round.
Our main indication for ECMO is severe cardiogenic shock and severe respiratory failure, not responding to standard medical management, but also patients under resuscitation when RUSC is not achieved within 10 minutes.
Okay, guys, we're at about the 10-minute mark. We've given 4 defibrillations and 3 doses of epi. Does anybody else have any suggestions on how to proceed at this point?
Maybe we should call an ECMO alert.
ECMO alert, everybody agree? Okay, I'll call the aides and get an ECMO alert. Hey, this is Katie calling from the ED. We have a patient here that we've been coding for about 10 minutes.
The way here in Hershey to call ECMO is you call 8888 and you get connected to the operator and you tell the operator that you want to call an ECMO alert, and the operator then sends out the page that contains the location of the patient, and the ECMO team can go to this location. The patient is normally in critical condition, and there's not a lot of time for decision making. The term ECMO stands for extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, and that term actually originates from the early days of ECMO, where ECMO was mainly used to support patients in respiratory failure.
Hi guys, we're the ECMO team. What's going on?
We have a 55-year-old male that came in with complaints of chest pain. He VFib arrested.
Most important information for us is information about the patient's medical condition, the length of resuscitation, and about the patient's social situation. Would the patient want that? Those extreme measures, or is there any order that the patient has specifically stated he would not like to be on life support? The majority of patients, when ECMO alert is called under emergency conditions, they will die if we would not support them.
Okay. Continue compressions.
When you call an ECMO alert, then you can expect that within a couple of minutes, we will bring the ECMO circuit as well as what we call the ECMO card. That's a card with a bunch of drawers where we do have all the equipment and cannulas stored on, so we have everything that we need at the site.
Andrew, can you get a stick of epi ready for our next rhythm check if you need it?
Typically, that's an ECMO attending. Most of the time, maybe 2 ECMO attendings, a nurse practitioner from the intensive care unit, and 2 nurses from the HVICCU who are bringing all the stuff and helping with setting up the patient, and oftentimes also a perfusionist. The ECMO device itself is comprised of cannulas, tubing, a pump head, an oxygenator, and is typically connected to the patient via his groin vessels, venous and femoral vessels. And the ECMO device is able to support the patient's cardiac as well as respiratory function. There are quite a few centers in Pennsylvania around us who can put patients on ECMO, but it's not only the procedure that's important, it's also what comes after the procedure. So the management of the patient who is put on ECMO, that is very important, and that needs a lot of manpower and a lot of experience.
We get a rhythm check?
Oftentimes it goes into heart transplant, sometimes it goes into lung transplant, sometimes it goes into implant of assist devices. And even though smaller institutions may have the technology, they will not be able to do all the management afterwards.
Heparin.
We're gonna unclamp. 10,000 units of heparin.
Unclamped. All right. Okay, I'm unclamping. Okay, we have 4.9 liters of flow at 2,200.
Okay, go ahead and stop the compressions. And let's go ahead and get a set of vital signs.
We have a set of 99%. We have good ejection on the monitor. And a mean pressure of 100.
All right, I'm increasing the RPMs. We're at 2,800 and we have a flow of 6.5.
Great, all right, let's go ahead and package the patient up and get him down to the HVICU.